Non-exercise activity thermogenesis and your metabolic process. A calorie is a unit of energy. It enters your body as the form of food. It is transformed into usable components such as glucose and amino acid. The metabolic process is all those things that happen in your body to keep it alive and moving. Your metabolic process breaks down sugar and transforms it into energy or stores it for future usage in your body. Your metabolic process manufactures the components your body needs to function. The slower your metabolic process is, the slower it processes your fuel into energy and the more it may store that energy waiting to be used in your body. What is the body's stored energy? It starts with calories. A calorie is a unit of energy. It enters your body as some type of food. It is transformed into usable elements such as glucose and amino acid. The body takes glucose and uses it to produce glycogen by a procedure called glycogenesis. The transformation into glycogen is finished with the help of insulin. Glycogen is stored in the liver and releases glucose when it is needed and energy when it is needed. Thermogenesis is the production of energy. The liver can just manage about 100 grams of glycogen. Excess glycogen is kept in your muscles. They too have a limit. It is higher than the liver's limitation. Muscles can deal with about 500 grams of glycogen. This is fantastic. Glycogen is there in your body to keep you going and you have some reserves kept in your fuel tank, aka your muscles. What happens when there is an excessive amount of glucose in your body? More insulin is produced to transform it to glycogen and the liver does its best to disperse it throughout your body. The overflow goes to your muscles and when they are at their storage limitation, the overflow is stored as fat. Fat has no limitations. Units of energy stored in your body are burned up by thermogenesis, which takes this fuel and runs your body with it. If you work out, energy is burned. If you exercise more, more energy is burned. Your metabolism relates to the speed at which your energy is burned. Non-exercise activity thermogenesis, NEAT, also uses energy, just not as much as exercise. NEAT refers to all the things that you do that are not done as exercise but as part of being a living being. You walk across the room because you need something from that part of the room. You open a door. Any basic movement you make is fueled by NEAT. Can NEAT help you lose weight? The function of the naturally taking place procedure in your body referred to as non-exercise activity thermogenesis is not to lose weight. However, the more non-exercise activity you have, the more thermogenesis will happen. There was an episode of the initial Star Trek that included aliens who used their brains instead of their bodies. They were frail animals with weak limbs and a big head to hold their huge brains. They could not move due to the fact that they had no muscles. They were small creatures. The current trend appears to be in the very same basic direction as these brainiacs headed. The focus was on their ability to think rather than their ability to move. The results that we, as humans, are encountering are not the same as the outcomes predicted in the fictional aliens. Bodies that do not move do not wither away. We do lose our muscles and our physical capability to move with dexterity. However, there is a propensity to gain weight. The constructed aspect of burning calories as our bodies perform the fundamental non-exercise activities of living, such as walking around and getting in and out of our seats, are not able to keep our systems operating in a functional manner. The system breaks down. Calories come into the body and triggers a flood of insulin to manage the storage of energy. More food enters the body before the stored energy is used and more insulin is produced. Quickly, the supply of insulin cannot manage the storage of calories. Due to the fact that we have not moved out of our chairs for hours, there is insufficient thermogenesis. Our body expects non-exercise activity thermogenesis. It is how we developed and what our organs expect. When your system runs out of balance, it cannot function properly. Simple NEAT does increase the calories burned above and beyond the calories used for basic physical functions. This can total up to a number of 100 calories a day. This is a conservative guess. Watering your plants for 15 minutes burns about 26 calories. If you did something like this, very little expenditure of energy 8 times a day, you would burn a little over 200 calories. In 17 and a half days, this would equal a pound of fat burnt. So yes, the brief answer is that NEAT will help you slim down. Some activities burn more calories. Moving furnishings and vacuuming takes more calories than watering your plants. When you are making an effort to move more, keep in mind that the more energy you take into moving, the more calories you will burn.
Exercise activity thermogenesis and your metabolic process.
A calorie is a unit of energy. It enters your body as the form of food. It is transformed into usable components such as glucose and amino acid.
The metabolic process is all those things that happen in your body to keep it alive and moving. Your metabolic process breaks down sugar and transforms it into energy or stores it for future usage in your body. Your metabolic process manufactures the components your body needs to function. The slower your metabolic process is, the slower it processes your fuel into energy and the more it may store that energy waiting to be used in your body. What is the body's stored energy? It starts with calories. A calorie is a unit of energy. It enters your body as some type of food. It is transformed into usable elements such as glucose and amino acid. The body takes glucose and uses it to produce glycogen by a procedure called glycogenesis. The transformation into glycogen is finished with the help of insulin. Glycogen is stored in the liver and releases glucose when it is needed and energy when it is needed. Thermogenesis is the production of energy. The liver can just manage about 100 grams of glycogen. Excess glycogen is kept in your muscles. They too have a limit. It is higher than the liver's limitation. Muscles can deal with about 500 grams of glycogen. This is fantastic. Glycogen is there in your body to keep you going and you have some reserves kept in your fuel tank, aka your muscles. What happens when there is an excessive amount of glucose in your body? More insulin is produced to transform it to glycogen and the liver does its best to disperse it throughout your body. The overflow goes to your muscles and when they are at their storage limitation, the overflow is stored as fat. Fat has no limitations. Units of energy stored in your body are burned up by thermogenesis, which takes this fuel and runs your body with it. If you work out, energy is burned. If you exercise more, more energy is burned. Your metabolism relates to the speed at which your energy is burned. Non-exercise activity thermogenesis, NEAT, also uses energy, just not as much as exercise. NEAT refers to all the things that you do that are not done as exercise but as part of being a living being. You walk across the room because you need something from that part of the room. You open a door. Any basic movement you make is fueled by NEAT. Can NEAT help you lose weight? The function of the naturally taking place procedure in your body referred to as non-exercise activity thermogenesis is not to lose weight. However, the more non-exercise activity you have, the more thermogenesis will happen. There was an episode of the initial Star Trek that included aliens who used their brains instead of their bodies. They were frail animals with weak limbs and a big head to hold their huge brains. They could not move due to the fact that they had no muscles. They were small creatures. The current trend appears to be in the very same basic direction as these brainiacs headed. The focus was on their ability to think rather than their ability to move. The results that we, as humans, are encountering are not the same as the outcomes predicted in the fictional aliens. Bodies that do not move do not wither away. We do lose our muscles and our physical capability to move with dexterity. However, there is a propensity to gain weight. The constructed aspect of burning calories as our bodies perform the fundamental non-exercise activities of living, such as walking around and getting in and out of our seats, are not able to keep our systems operating in a functional manner. The system breaks down. Calories come into the body and triggers a flood of insulin to manage the storage of energy. More food enters the body before the stored energy is used and more insulin is produced. Quickly, the supply of insulin cannot manage the storage of calories. Due to the fact that we have not moved out of our chairs for hours, there is insufficient thermogenesis. Our body expects non-exercise activity thermogenesis. It is how we developed and what our organs expect. When your system runs out of balance, it cannot function properly. Simple NEAT does increase the calories burned above and beyond the calories used for basic physical functions. This can total up to a number of 100 calories a day. This is a conservative guess. Watering your plants for 15 minutes burns about 26 calories. If you did something like this very little expenditure of energy 8 times a day, you would burn a little over 200 calories. In 17 and a half days, this would equal a pound of fat burnt. So yes, the brief answer is that NEAT will help you slim down. Some activities burn more calories. Moving furnishings and vacuuming takes more calories than watering your plants. When you are making an effort to move more, keep in mind that the more energy you take into moving, the more calories you will burn.